Hey, I'm Dr. Sebastian Gonzalez from the Performance Place. Today we're going to highlight a piece of medical imaging called musculoskeletal ultrasound, or MSK ultrasound. Now, ultrasound is familiar, sounds like a familiar word to a lot of people that have had it done, mainly for therapeutic reasons. And the reason when you go in, they have the jelly and they put it on you and they kind of rub and like you stay there for like 5 to 10 minutes and you get it done the next day, that's called therapeutic ultrasound. Diagnostic or medical ultrasound is the same type of technology that uses a computer screen, and you look inside and you see things like baby's faces and the sex of the baby and so on. So in this case, we're looking at muscles, tendons, ligaments, and fascia. Those types of things can all be visualized very, very accurately and detailed on something like a musculoskeletal ultrasound. Now, I want to thank all the viewers already that have shared and liked our videos. We really appreciate it. It helps us get good information out there to the public that obviously you can't call and get a doctor to talk to you all the time. So we'll try to relay the stuff that we think is most important for our viewers and things they should be familiar with in regards to their healthcare. One of the more common conditions I see of the foot is something we're going to use today. It's very prevalent amongst runners. It's called peroneal tendonitis or peroneal tendinosis. You probably see on various Runner's World forums or different types of forums of people having this and not knowing what to do about it or knowing what it is for that matter. So we're going to use an ultrasound to see. This is actually a marathon runner who started running a little bit sooner than we wanted her to and jumped the miles a little bit faster than we wanted her to. So she presented with pain on the outside part of the foot as well as a little bit into the ankle going up to the side of the calf or the leg as you want to call it. So this is an ultrasound we did about 2 weeks after she presented with this type of pain. Now really to get the most out of this video, you're going to have to understand what orientation we're looking at the image in when it comes up. So first off, realize a tendon is almost like a piece of rope, and I'll grab one here. Okay, you got a piece of rope. All right. And everyone's used to looking at it this way. However, when we look at the image, we're actually taking a view like we're cutting it in half. So you're going to be looking down the line like this. So they're going to look like two little circles. So we're looking around the border here to see if there's any black and irritation to the tendon itself. You can look at them in this view. However, on this image, we're looking them down the line, or I like to call cross-sectional.
This we're going to be able to see synovial thickening. So let me...
the cross-sectional area?
Yes, some cross-section. And there are two tendons, the longus and brevis, are stacked. They're like one and two. They're kind of like stacked right on top of each other.
I see that now, black already.
Yeah, you can see it already. Let me try to find like a good... Like right here is a decent spot. So take that picture. But I don't have to move too far just to see like that, the difference between that. And if I come back a little bit more proximally, that's almost normal right there in that spot. But I go a little tiny bit distal, and you see the black inflammation, the swelling thickens up of the peroneal longus and brevis. That's it.
Musculoskeletal ultrasound is a very, very good thing at using it, looking at very superficial tendons like this. And as you can see, if you move your foot around, you can almost feel these tendons pop up. MRI is also good, and a lot of people do get MRIs done. However, with high deductible plans and so on, MRIs can get a little bit more costly. MRIs are not bad. Let me put it out there already. Okay, I'm not bashing an MRI. However, if you have something like musculoskeletal ultrasound, you can compare both sides to see what's normal. You can go up and down the tendon. You can check a lot of things within a shorter amount of time, and actually the cost is usually much less. So that's something you should really consider if you're not using that, as first off, as a medical provider, but also as a patient. If you're worried about cost or actually being the claustrophobic nature of an MRI and being in that tube, you don't have to do that here. You're right out in the open. You just have jelly in your skin and a transducer, and you're looking at a screen, and that's it. Now, if you want some more free information, we have links to our things we've posted throughout the video on the sides. You can click on those. You'll be shot to our email feed, which has articles, videos, audio, or actually podcasts that we have here in the office with different types of medical providers. We try to really give the best to our audience and the best stuff that we know. We spend a lot for our education, so we really want to share that. Also, you can subscribe to our YouTube feeds, and it's going to be a little tiny emblem on the side. It's been there throughout the entire thing, or you can just find us on YouTube. But either way, please link up with us. I think we have good stuff to share, and I hope you enjoyed.